you can see, we have made our way into the kitchen, and we're gonna make something French. You know, even when it comes to sandwiches, nobody really prepares food quite like the French, do they?
Absolutely not.
Yep, so showing us how to make a melty, cheesy, classic croque madame, welcome executive chef Chris Feldmeier to our home. Welcome, Chris. Look how beautiful that is. Look at those beautiful creations
in front of you guys.
Oh, good.
Kim, Allie, Ken, you guys, may we? That means, but yes. May we, you may. Dig in. So, Chris, what is the difference between a classic croque monsieur and croque madame?
Croque madame has a egg on top. The croque monsieur is just the bechamel toasted beautifully on top.
So what makes it female versus male?
I would say that the egg on top, kind of like a hat, I believe is the actual, the traditional term, or like the story behind it.
Oh, that's why, because it looks like that, like the sandwich was wearing a hat like a lady. How cute is that?
That is adorable.
And directly translated, it just means
Mr. or Mrs. Crunch, which is one of my favorite names for a sandwich ever.
I mean, seriously, you could call it Mr. or Mrs. Crunch and it would taste just as delicious, right?
Absolutely.
So one of the key things to a great croque madame or croque monsieur is the bechamel, because
yes,
otherwise it would just be a fancy grilled cheese or ham and cheese, but the bechamel really elevates it.
It adds a richness to the sandwich. It adds like a little bit more body to it. It's just not necessarily just the normal grilled cheese. You get the crunch of the crispy bread and the butter, and then you just get this like luscious, rich bechamel on top.
All right, well, we're gonna start with your bechamel, and yours is a little different than the usual bechamel, isn't it?
Yes, I use a bechamel that's more of a traditionally Italian style bechamel, so we have the addition of onions and nutmeg to this.
Okay.
Usually there is a little bit of bay leaf and salt and black peppercorn and the whole thing, but this, the onion and the nutmeg are
make it a little different.
Nutmeg?
Nutmeg.
Right.
It's definitely more of a,
yeah.
So what goes in first? We've got our melted butter.
So we've got our melted butter. We then add our flour.
Okay. And I know it's important when you're making bechamel to really sit over it, because it can go from perfect to burned very quickly.
Absolutely. You definitely, as you are adding the flour to it, especially in the beginning and making the, what is called a roux, thank you. The roux is very important that you want to combine all of the flour into it so you don't get little tiny chunks of flour when you're cooking it out and you add the milk to it. So we are going to cook this roux.
And you're also toasting out that flour flavor.
Exactly.
Right?
So you kind of want to take this as far as you possibly can. You see it kind of turns into like almost like a Play-Doh type of thing that's boiling on the stove.
Okay.
So once it starts to cook out, you will see it starts to slowly change color.
And just for sake of television, we add the milk.
We add the milk.
This is how a very fancy sauce in my house starts off, called cheese sauce.
Exactly.
Well, I put it on broccoli for my kids.
It's actually, this is actually very, very close to what you would do to make a mac and cheese sauce. So we are going to add our onions.
Now with the onion, the onion is just for flavoring. It doesn't melt down.
It does not melt down. It just adds a little flavor.
It kind of chop
cuts
it up,
the rest of it. Not at all. You just want to leave it hold, and it's like the acid inside the onion kind of helps like break down the milk a little bit and add a little bit of an extra flavor to it. It adds like an extra depth to it.
And you don't really know what it is, but you're like, why is this bechamel a little different?
Exactly. So our bay leaf just goes in right there.
Make sure to take that out before.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So
but we're gonna strain this all out, so we don't have to worry about that necessarily as much. Peppercorn.
Okay.
And
nutmeg.
And then our nutmeg at the end.
There we go. Now, how long would you say would that take for it to come together and start to become sort of thick?
It'll start to thicken up right away, and just because it thickens up doesn't necessarily mean it's done. You want to make sure that you cook it long enough, as you said, to take the starch out of it and that kind of like floury flavor. Mm-hmm. And once that changes and it's thick, the bechamel is completely done.
And so we'll swap it out and take a look at that beautiful
bechamel
right there. Look at that. Oh,
product.
So good. So, all right, so while our bechamel sits on the stovetop for a minute, we are going to build the sandwich. So this is pretty basic.
Absolutely. So we are going to take the bread, butter one side of it.
Generously.
Oh, obviously generous. This is a French sandwich. We have plenty of butter.
Do you like to use salted butter when you do this?
I never use salted butter because I figure you can add salt as you need to it. It's one of those ingredients that should be added per taste for whoever is making it, especially if you're cooking at home.
Perfect. I love how much butter you put on there.
Oh, yeah, we have to put a lot on there. We want to make sure that we brown this up really nice.
Okay.
So once it is, we flip this over. We then add our ham.
Again, generously.
Generously adding ham. You want to make sure you can walk off that walk around Paris and the Eiffel Tower.
There you go.
So you have plenty of time. So we're just going to go for it all. We're going to add all that ham.
And you're using Gruyere cheese.
Gruyere cheese, so it's like a Swiss cheese, any kind of like sharper Swiss cheese. I use Fontina sometimes as well for this. But anything that has like a nice like flavor and bite that'll kind of cut through the ham. And
you're not shy with the cheese.
Oh, no. I mean, if it's here, why not use it?
Yeah. And if it's a bistro sandwich, you want it to be like, you know, hearty.
I guess so.
I'm just going to put the other one on there. And then you can butter that, and we just put it back on the plate because we have the other one over here going. And you're using a sourdough bread?
Sourdough bread.
But would they use, they would use a baguette in France.
They would, they have all sorts of different things of different shapes and sizes of bread, but I think that they just a sourdough in general, because most of the starters in France for bread are sourdough starters, usually by grape. So
okay, all right. Oops, so we'll just place this back over here, and as you can see, we already have. Well, we made a mess there, but don't you worry about that. I'll clean that up. Over here, we have already started toasting our sandwich. On the stovetop, and just a cast iron skillet?
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
There you go.
Now I'm understanding why this bread is so good.
Exactly.
With all that butter that just
tons of butter.
So how long do we toast it?
We just want to toast it for probably like 2 or 3 minutes on each side. Once the pan starts to heat up, it'll obviously start to toast a lot faster.
Okay.
We just want to toast it until it is golden brown and delicious, or GBD as we like to call it.
Love that. And then we cover with the bechamel.
Then we take the bechamel, absolutely.
Okay, because then it goes into the oven on broil.
And once again, we are going to generously add bechamel to this. We do not want to be cheap with it because we are making a delicious, rich lunch sandwich.
Okay, so in the oven she goes, our croque madame. Well, she's still a monsieur right now.
Yeah, she's still a monsieur. And we're
she's not a madame until she gets her
only,
pet.
Only the egg makes her a madame.
That is only the difference. This is now, see, this is a Mr. Crunch now.
And then we add our egg that we fried, and we dig in.
Absolutely.
Yes, you do, and you will be happy when you do.
Is it wrong to pick it up and eat it?
I don't know. I wasn't sure. I was using the knife and fork.
Let's try this out.
Because we're in France now.
Thank
you so much, Chris.
Thank
Great
you guys
job.
Very much.
Super tasty. Have a bite, you guys. Full recipe will be at HallmarkChannel.com.